Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at paragraph and line spacing in Pages. So to make your documents look nice in Pages, you want to pay a lot of attention to line spacing and paragraph spacing. So for instance, I have some sample paragraphs here and I can bring up the inspector, and in the inspector I can go to the text inspector here. And under the text inspector I can see line spacing and also spacing for before and after paragraphs. So let's select the first paragraph, and you can see I can change the line spacing here, and I'll only change the one in the first paragraph. So typically in a normal document you want to select all and then go ahead and change the line spacing. Of course, wider line spacing means it will be easier to read, but of course it'll take up more paper as well. So you want to pick up something that suits whatever it is you're writing and how long it is and your audience. But in addition to line spacing, you've got paragraph spacing. Now you can see that there's a little more space between each paragraph here, and that is reflected over here in after paragraph. There's 14 points between each one. I can shrink that back down to nothing, and now you can see the paragraphs run into each other, which may be suitable for some things. You can add more, and you can also do before and after, which of course kind of look the same depending upon how your document is laid out, but they are slightly different. Here, if I add space before paragraphs, you can see it's not adding it to the beginning of the document, only between paragraphs. So in this case it's kind of the same. Now another way to separate paragraphs a little more is to indent the first line of each paragraph. And you do that here by going to Tabs in the inspector. And here's where I can indent the first line, and it's measured here in whatever the measurement is I have set in preferences, in this case inches. So I can bring in that first line here of each paragraph to make it look a little bit better. I can also bring in every other line like that. So in some cases you may want to do something like this. And you can also do it on the right side as well, just to bring it in, which helps distinguish a specific paragraph. Like for instance, I wanted to bring in this one here in particular to bring that one out a little bit or separate it from the rest of the text. Of course, in many cases it's going to be a combination of these things, to have a little bit of a paragraph indent and also have some space after each paragraph to create a very nice, easy to read document. And when you make adjustments like this to paragraphs, sometimes you end up with different things. Like this paragraph has different line spacing, indentation, and also how much space is after the paragraph. And say I want to apply that somewhere else. Well, I can just have the cursor inside of that paragraph, and I can copy paragraph style from the format menu. And I can put the cursor in another paragraph, and I can paste the paragraph style. And you can see it's an easy way to bring that style elsewhere. So I can select all and paste paragraph style, and you can see I've put it all there. You could also, of course, make a style from this. So I can bring up the styles drawer here. I can use these paragraph styles. I can add a new one. I'm just going to use the default name there. And now I can, if I were to change this, for instance, I can bring up the inspector here, change the line spacing, and then I can apply freeform 2, which is the name that I gave to that, and you can see it put it back there. So you can use paragraph styles to take all of these attributes and apply them to paragraphs very easily. And another thing you can do, and you don't see this done very often, is to put lines between paragraphs. So I can select all these paragraphs here. I can go in text here and switch over to more, and then borders and rules, I can put a line there, and you can see I could set it to the top, bottom, both, or completely surround the area, which of course isn't going to divide the paragraph. So I want to probably just do, say, bottom like that, and then I can set the color, I can set the thickness for each line. So in various situations this could also help, not just to separate all the paragraphs maybe, but perhaps to highlight a single one. For instance, if I were to take this away here and say I wanted to highlight this specific paragraph, I could set up a line that completely surrounds it here, so it kind of sets it apart from that. And that's all, while that's not even a separate text box. So you could of course do a separate text box, but this way the text flows in here. If I add more to there, it'll push this down and this text will flow no matter how I change things throughout the document. So I hope you found this look at paragraph line spacing useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.